These people that live here, if you could get them to talk to you, would probably tell you, hey, we hear them all the time. It doesn't benefit them to be seen by us. They just want to be left alone. You know, we don't go out and make them do stuff. We go out and put ourselves in a position where they want to come do stuff with us.
It's a shaggy, upright, two-legged bipedal primate that is anywhere from, I mean, youngsters can be 4 to 5 feet tall, maxing out at anything from 8 to 9, 10 feet tall.
2008, at night, I actually saw a big figure come up along the side of a road. It was about, the two red eyes were about 9 feet off the ground, and this big black figure kind of looked at me and then just walked down the road.
We were driving down one of the back roads on the skid road, and we had one about 100 feet in front of us walk right across the road.
Over on the Olympic Peninsula, I saw another one through a night vision scope, and it's blown me away every single time.
First smelled it, and it's the most rankest smell you've ever smelled, and once you smell it, you'll never forget it. I've had 5 sightings at this point. You will have a to the core fear like you've never felt fear in your life. It's that kind of fear where people, you know, crap your pants in a way. It is just visceral. They could hear it walking in the woods as it walked around them, and they could hear it vocalizing at them. And then the straw that broke the camel's back was when it threw the big boulder into the road behind them. Usually when they're throwing rocks or sticks, they're trying to get you to leave.
If you're trying to hurt them, then all bets are off.
I can't get in there.
But we'll go no further than we feel safe. We found that if they want to hit you, they could hit you, and they seem to be very accurate with the rock throwing.
If you tell people you go look for Bigfoot or something, since most of the society doesn't believe in it, they automatically think you're crazy. Well, that's fine. I really don't care what other people think, but no, I don't generally walk up and say, hey, you know what I do for fun? I go out in the woods and look for Sasquatch.
No. Okay. Based on the guy's description of the spot, our feeling was that he was up on that ridgetop right up there.
Yeah, this is a it's called a bionic ear. It picks up noises more than what we can hear without the device. So it's just an aid.
I was down in Morton last summer, up on these logging roads. I heard something that sounded like a lion. It sounded like a lion's roar. Just this. It sounded like sounded like a monster. You really gonna get me on a video playing with poop?
Scat.
I mean,
excretion.
Yeah, cause you never know. I mean, you never know when something's gonna be something weird. But hey, this is Tyler. We are at the end of our road. We're gonna hang out here for a couple minutes, and I was going to put out a couple of calls. Should I do a howl or should I do a whoop?
And then we listen to see if anything calls back.
I am recording, and we got stuff going on here.
I heard birds, I heard squirrels, and then some strange stuff, and I don't know what to account for that, but.
Did you get it recorded?
I did.
Okay.
So, and I can't tell you what that strange stuff was, because I couldn't make sense out of it.
But if you start through, really looking into the evidence and reading books and all, and boy, it just gets to the point where you just can't, the idea that it's all a hoax and all hallucinations, especially when you got multiple sightings. I mean, if everyone hallucinating the same thing, are they all making up this story? there's that old adage, you know, the worst day fishing is still better than the best day at work. And it's kind of like coming out. I mean, even if you don't have any experiences for years, you're still out, you know, in nature. As hobbies go, you know, it's not a bad one. I guess you'd probably have to say that would be frame 352 from the Patterson-Gimlin film.